I gotta go, but I dropped by here to tell somebody that if you stay with God and go all the way, you ain't seen nothing yet. If you keep encouraging your pastor to keep doing what God has called him to do, if you keep pushing him and say, preach on, pastor, keep leading us in the way of God, I want you to know that you ain't seen nothing yet, huh? I'm finished with you, church. I'm not a hooping preacher, so I got to use illustrations to get people on their feet at the end of the sermon. So all I got is a closing illustration. I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to turn around and take my seat. I'll never forget my beautiful wife. We've been together now for 11 years, and I remember when our first Christmas that we had together, I was a broke college student, didn't have a dime in my pocket, and didn't have a job that was bringing in a dime. I had a friend who was the manager of a car wash, and he called me, and I have no money to buy my wife a present for Christmas. And I said to myself, this woman gonna dump me if I don't show up at her house with a Christmas present. I called all my friends. I even called Petway. Wouldn't even loan me no money to buy my wife a Christmas present. Yeah, but my good friend that worked at the car wash, he called me on Christmas Eve. He said, Bolden, you want a job? I said, yes, I want a job. He said, show up at 9 o'clock and come on down here and work at the car wash. I went to the car wash and I made $300 in tips on my first day of work. See, some of y'all, see, you need to go to car wash and get a job. What you don't know is I worked at the car wash for 5 years. I bought my first Lincoln at the car wash. I bought my first house at the car wash. I took care of my daughter from the car. But some of y'all got too much pride for that. But anyway, that's another sermon. I went to the car wash and I worked one day and made $300. And I went to the mall and spent every dime of it on buying my wife Christmas present. Oh, and you should have seen me. We went to her grandmother's house to exchange gifts on Christmas. I walked in the door so arrogant with my head up high. I had a big old bag, walked in the house, set it up under the Christmas tree. I couldn't wait till it was time to bring out the presents. And my brother, who's married to her sister, he had this one little gift for her. Bought her some little boots from Baker's. I said, oh, that's nice and cute right there. But you wait till I start putting this stuff up out of my bag. So he gave his wife her present, and I sat there with my, I said, sit out right here, baby. I pulled up a chair. Watch this. I went in the bag and I pulled out a gift. I said, there you go, sweetie. I said, how you like that? She said, oh, baby, this is the best gift I ever had. She said, thank you so much. I said, hold on. I said, I got another gift. I went in the bag and I got another gift, and I set it in front of her. I said, here you go. How you like that gift? She said, oh, baby, I thought you couldn't do no better than that, but I want to thank you for that gift. I went in the bag one more time. I said, you think that's something? Wait till I get this other gift. I went in the bag and pulled out one more gift, and then she said, thank you, sweetie. And somebody said, Pastor Bolden, what are you trying to tell us today? I'm trying to tell you that every time my wife told me thank you, I went in the bag and pulled out another gift. And here's what I want to tell somebody, that every time you tell God thank you, he'll reach in the bag and he'll pull out another gift. I wish I had somebody in this church tonight who will stand up on your feet and tell God thank you. Tell him thank you for my house. Thank you for my car. Thank you for my job. Thank you for some food to eat. And every time, I said every time, you tell him thank you, he goes in his bag and pulls out another gift. Somebody ought to shout in this church tonight. You ought to give God the praise in here tonight. And don't care how your neighbor looking at you, go ahead and praise him anyway. And when they ask you why you praising him, tell them because the word on the street is that when praises go up, blessings come down. So tell them I'll shout to get my next blessing.
Doors of the church open. Let us stand.